T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We have main engine start, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff. Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
At the time of the Challenger, I was in graduate school.
Good roll program confirmed.
I was 15 years old and a freshman in high school.
I was 16 at the time.
Engines beginning throttling down now at 94%.
That day I was a sophomore and I was in a high school.
We'll throttle down to 65% shortly.
I remember that day vividly. Because I happened to be attending graduate school at a school of education.
Velocity 2,257 feet per second. Altitude 4.3 nautical miles. Downrange distance 3 nautical miles.
But it was a big deal because of Kristen McAuliffe.
So the 25th Space Shuttle mission is now on the way after more delays than NASA cares to count. This morning it looked as though they were not going to be able to get off.
15 seconds. Velocity 2,900 feet per second. Altitude 9 nautical miles. Downrange distance 7 nautical miles. Flight controllers here looking very carefully at the situation. Obviously a major malfunction. We have a report from the flight dynamics officer that the vehicle has exploded. Flight director confirms that. We are looking at checking with the recovery forces to see what can be done at this point.
On January 28, 1986, the world saw the worst disaster in space history. All 7 astronauts aboard the Space Shuttle Challenger were killed 1 minute and 13 seconds into the launch, following a string of fatal errors and disagreements. This was the second time NASA had lost astronauts, the first being the fire that killed Roger Chaffee, Ed White, and Gus Grissom of Apollo 1 in 1967. The Space Shuttle program, also known as the STS, Space Transportation System, began in 1972. It was part of what could be considered the third stage of the space age for America, following early satellite launches and the first manned missions into space, and the Apollo program. After tests of the main engines and the shuttle's ability to glide to a safe landing,
they go. They have separation.
The world saw STS-1 as Space Shuttle Columbia launched into the void of space. The first space shuttles delivered satellites into orbit, performed experiments in microgravity, and tested systems for later flights. 24 space shuttle launches had taken place before the launch of the Challenger. Several engineers at both Morton Thiokol, builder of the solid rocket boosters, and Rockwell International, maker of the rocket's engines, realized that low temperatures were a cause of gas blow-by in the solid rocket boosters, and were stunned at how a launch with expected 26-degree temperatures could even be considered, knowing that the recommended temperature was at least 40 degrees. After Ronald Reagan approved the Rogers Commission report to investigate the tragedy, it was discovered that, in fact, stiff O-rings caused by cold temperatures caused gas to leak and rupture the main fuel tank, destroying the orbiter and killing everyone on board. In 1984, President Reagan announced that in order to further the education of children across the nation, a teacher would be sent into space. Over 11,000 teachers filled out the 11-page application, hoping to be chosen for this honor. Krista McAuliffe was a high school teacher in Concord, New Hampshire, when she learned about the unique opportunity to travel into space. After being chosen, she renewed interest in space travel and the space age. She became a favorite of the press and the public, quoted saying, "If you're offered a seat on a rocket ship, don't ask what seat. Just get on."
It was amazing to think about a real person going up in space, and so there's a ton of excitement around it. Even though I was young, it was very obvious that this was a really big deal. And one of the reasons it was so obvious is that we got to watch it in school.
I remember being in the cafeteria in the lunchroom, and somebody heard that the space shuttle had exploded, and then, you know, rumors sort of spread verbally from one person to another. No one had phones or anything or social media that they could check. It was all just word of mouth, but still, it spread incredibly quickly throughout everybody in the cafeteria.
I do remember vividly sitting in a classroom with 30 other students listening intently to the takeoff. And I do remember seeing the explosion on TV and there just being dead silence. It was just quiet. It was so profound in its moment in history. It was such a momentous occasion that the country was really focused on that Reagan got on TV and talked about it. And I remember sitting on the TV with my brothers and my parents, listening to him talk and trying to make sense of what had happened.
Today is a day for mourning and remembering. Nancy and I are pained to the core by the tragedy of the Shuttle Challenger. We know we share this pain with all of the people of our country. This is truly a national loss.
We would go to the library every time there was a launch and sit around probably a 17-inch TV on a stand. But those were moments. The prospect of a launch, even when the Challenger still hadn't lost its excitement, and because Krista McAuliffe, being a teacher, and particularly a teacher from New England, there was great regional interest in that. So it was incredibly sad for the loss of all those families.
An MIT graduate and an expert in laser physics, Ronald McNair was one of the mission specialists on board the Challenger and was the second African-American in space. He trained for a year at NASA in 1978 and became a mission specialist for the space shuttle missions.
I heard about an astronaut on the Challenger named Ron McNair, and his brother had written a children's book. Ron stood up to segregation in Mississippi, where when he was about 10 years old, he wasn't allowed to take out library books. And I was so impressed with the story and with Ron McNair's brother's version of the story that I made sure I had a copy of the book in my classroom. My students know about Ron McNair, and it kind of has formed, and it's a really great way to talk about racial segregation in our country, and a really great way to talk about how anyone can stand up to it, even if you're 10 years old.
The Challenger tragedy changed the lives of millions of Americans, and the deaths of seven brave astronauts left a lasting mark on the history of space travel. However, the families of the astronauts worked together to take the lessons learned from the tragedy of the Challenger and positively influence America. The Challenger Center for Space Science Education, an educational foundation, has inspired hundreds of thousands of young people. The Dr. Ronald E. McNair Educational Science Literacy Foundation promotes science education for students of all ages. The technical flaws of the Challenger have become a key aspect of engineering curriculums at colleges and universities. NASA also moved away from the rigid hierarchical structure that caused the opinions of engineers to go ignored. Additionally, the position of launch director was isolated from its previous administrative duties. Safety improvements were made to the shuttle's thermal protection system. And this year, NASA and the Challenger Center will collaborate to perform Krista McAuliffe's experiments on board the International Space Station. The Challenger and its crew of Krista McAuliffe, Gregory Jarvis, Judith Resnick, Francis Scobie, Ronald McNair, Mike Smith, and Ellison Onizuka changed the scientific community, inspired millions, and united a country.
Thank you. Thank you.